Hi, this is Divya Priya, Assistant Professor, Bishabiba College. Now I would like to discuss about the topic biosignal and the biosignal acquisition process. The main aim of this presentation is about to tell you what a biosignal is and how it can be analyzed and processed to interpret the results accurately. With no delay, we can move on to the presentation. In biosignal acquisition process, one must know what a biosignal is. Biosignal is a human body variable that can be measured and monitored and that can provide information on the health status of the individual. In most cases, it is an electrical voltage, or in other words, it is a function that conveys information about the behavior or attributes of some physiological phenomenon, and it is a biological quantity or magnitude exhibiting variation in time or variation in space, which is potentially a signal that provides information on the status of a biological system. Various biosignals available in our body. I need to tell some of the biosignals here. A V of T biosignal, which provides information on cardiac physiology or pathology, can be diagnosed in an ECG instrument. A mu X, Y biosignal, for which the attenuation coefficient value is measured for each patient voxel at the position X, Y of a patient, can be diagnosed in a CTT tomogram. A ST of X, Y, Z biosignal, for which the hydrogen density is measured for each patient voxel at the position X, Y, Z, can be diagnosed in a 3D MRI image. Biosignals are material carriers of the information about the state of the biological system. Therefore, they can be processed by four steps as I have shown here. The first step will be the data acquisition process. The second step will be the amplification process. The third step will be the display and storage of signals. And the final step will be the interpretation of the biosignals. In data acquisition process, the biosignals are converted as electrical signals, which can be fed into the transducers or sensors for further processing. Since biosignals are analog signals, it can be amplified properly by the pre-amplifiers or filters, which include computational and parameter extraction. The display and storage of biosignals are to be removing the possible artifacts and the event detection process. And the interpretation and classification of the biosignals, which includes pattern recognition, tells about the diagnostic results of a patient. Biosignal measurement and parameter identification initiate by the acquisition of a diagnostic data in the form of image or time series that carry valuable information related to underlying physical process. Biosignals from the patient is carried into the electrical probes as electrical signals, which is fed into the transducers. A transducer is a device that converts energy from one form to the another. Here, the process of energy conversion is to gather information but not to transform energy. The analog signal, which is usually required to be amplified using bioamplifiers or filters, which is the most important step in the data processing. There are various types of filters available, like isolation amplifier, chopper amplifier, medical amplifier or bridge amplifier, which can be used according to the types of biosignals which are to be diagnosed appropriately. Some biosignals require to be amplified using the high pass or low pass filters as well. Since most signal processing is easier to implement using digital methods, the analog signal is converted to digital format using analog to digital converter. Once converted, the signal is often stored or buffered in the memory. From this step, the digital signal processing starts. The digital processing is applied on the digitized signal, which is mainly characterized as artifact removal methods and event detection methods. There are four different origins of artifacts, which includes physiological variability, environmental noise interference, transducer artifacts, and electrical noise. Such a noisy signal can be smoothed out using the filters, and finally can be analyzed and predicted using by removing the noise, smoothing the signal, and detecting the threshold in peaks of interest.